Hello everyone, welcome to watch Soya eLearning channel. Our topic today is about Soya lift control. What's lift control? How does lift control function work? Actually, the concept of lift control is very simple to be understood. If the building is equipped with lift control functions, we can say only the user who has a permitted card can present their card to press the floor button for the specified floors, but the outsider or an allowed user without present a permitted card could not press any floor button to access any floors. Nowadays, lift control has become a safe and convenient way for user access and management in a building. Therefore, today we'd like to introduce everyone how to use Soya device to configure a lift control system. Let's see lift control procedure. What shall we do to configure a lift control system? Okay, basically we need to do three steps. Step 1, selection hardware for lift control. Step 2, learn lift control structure and wiring of our selection device. Step 3, set up device and added the user card for accessible floors. Firstly, we will learn how to select hardware. Which device should be selected for Soya lift control? You can see the table has listed all device items for configuring a lift control system. Totally, we need 5 kinds of device. Item 1. Select the controller type. Soya mainly provides 2 kinds of controller series. H controller and E controller. All of Soya controllers support lift control function. When you receive a lift control project, the first point you should consider is about how many floors will be controlled in the building and how many users will be permitted to access the lift. If the building including basement is less than 32 floors, and the user is less than 3,000, you can select H controller. If the user in the building is less than 1,024, plastic housing 721H is the most stable and recommended model for lift control. If the user member is between 1,000 to 3,000, 725H is the most recommended model. Metal housing 3 series controllers is easily interfered by electrical equipment in lift environment than plastic model. The interference possibly cause insensitive signal or short reading current. Hereby, controller with plastic housing model is mostly recommended in lift control than metal controller. Item 2. We need a TTL to S45 converter. AR-321L 485 is used for edge controller. Item 3. Lift control board. Soya lift control board is building 16 relay that can be connected up to 16 floors. Each edge controller can connect it to unit of lift control board for 32 stop. Item 4. Select power supply. Soya provides 2 kinds of power supply. 12 watts power supply for edge controller. Lift control board is suggested to use separate power supply. 15 watts. 2.4 amperes. Item 5. If your clients need to manage lift control via computer, you should select the converter. There are 2 kinds of converter type that can be used as communicated bridge between edge controller and computer. USB converter 321cm and TCP/IP converter 727cm. What's the difference advantage of choice E controller? If the building is more than 32 floors, and the use in more than 3,000. Now, we have to trust e-controller. E-sales controller support to connected 4 units of lift controller board for 64 floors, and the user capacity is also up to 16,000. The second difference is TTL to S485 converter. 5 watts AR-725L. 485 is used for e-controller. Other 3 items is same with edge controller. After complete hardware selection, let's see the picture. It shows a clear structure. How does SOYA device we choose work in lift cage? Usually, we install SOYA controller behind the lift control panel, then connect it to lift control board via TTL converter. Lift control board is placed on the top of lift cage. Each relay on lift control board is connected to each push button on lift button panel. Elevator engineer can use key to open service cabinet to switch power on off of all device for routine maintenance or emergency situation. This page shows a simple structure for lift control. Only one option for edge controller. Connect the edge controller to lift control board via TTL converter, AR-321L, 485, and connect it to computer for management via USB converter or TCP/IP converter. However, we can see there are 2 options for e-controller. Option 1. Use TTL converter, AR-725L, 485 between e-controller and lift control board. Option 2. Directly connect e-controller to lift control board via S485 host port. Okay, after complete hardware selection and learn lift control structure, we are going to set up of lift control to work. We will separately introduce edge control and e-controller. There are 2 steps we shall set up. Step 1. Enable controller with lift control function. Step 2. Assign each user card to accessible floor. Each step can be set up via hardware method or software method. As for edge controller with keypad type, we use gray cable on connector 1 as lift control signal to connect it with TTL converter. The default function of gray cable is used for alarm output in door control application. Once the controller is used for lift control, we can modify the parameter and then use the same gray cable for lift control signal instead of alarm output signal. As for LCD controller, we use yellow-white cable and connect it to a lift control signal to connect it with TTL converter. About lift control board, we need to note, modify dip switch to right location. If lift control board connects with edge controller, baud rate value shall be adjusted to 4800. Adjust the switch 5 to on and switch 6 to off. In the case 4800 baud rate. Up down the wiring and power on all device, we can set up lift control. This page, we will learn how to use hardware method to set up keypad controller. Step 1. Enable lift control function. After entering programming mode, press the key to give command 24*, value 2. Then the controller will be enable lift control function. Step 2. Assign permitted floor for each user card. Command 27 for single floor setting. For example, user address 45 is permitted to access only floor 24. You can directly press key to 27*. 00045*24#. Command 21 for multi-flow setting. For example, user address 116.8 is permitted to access two flow, the 6th flow and the 20th flow. We should give two types of command. Regarding to flow chart, flow 6 belong to set 0 at the 3rd location. Flow 20 belong to set 2 at the 50th location. We should follow the chart to give the location with value 1 and the other location give value 0. For LCD controller, we can follow menu on screen to complete all setting in short time. Then keypad controller. Step 1, enable lift control. Quick command is 54. We should choose terminal port to 1 lift control board code. Step 2, assign accessible flow to each user card. For single flow, quick command is 24. We can direct the put user address and give the flow number. For multi-flows, quick command is 25. Put user address and give the value for different flow. Value 1 means permitted to access. Value 2 means cannot access. Maybe some clients think it's not very easy and fast way of editing user card by hardware. We can also use Soya software, 701 software, to edit the user card. Before assigning the user card for accessible flow, make sure you have added the card to be a valid card. Then, execute 701 client. Click icon, hit user added on menu bar. Click tools box, then find out the windows of user access flow edit. After entering user access flow edit window, you can see the setting will be more easier. Just choose user address. Pick the flow number. You can choose different flows by lightly clicking your mouse. The user flow setting can be downloaded to controller you connected. There are three notes for your attention. If you need to download our user flow card setting at one time, please click save to save current data. After complete all setting, click read all to download all to controller. If you want to check the user current data, please click read current to read data from controller. If you want to check all user data, please click read all to read all data from controller. Another simple and fast way is to edit user flow in text file. To select the access flow for each user card, Y means allowed to access. Dot means cannot access. After complete all user flow setting, upload the file, back file, load from text file of option, and download all user information to controller. From now on, let us introduce how to use eController for lift control. We have learned eController support 64 flows and 16,000 user card capacity. Compare edge controller. Actually, one more advantage is eController provides three methods for lift control. Most of eController is building three ports that can be changed for lift control. Method 1 can directly communicate with lift control board without any converter. Method 2 and method 3 need TTL converter. But there are some notes for different methods. Method 1 will use TCP/IP interface for networking connection. It is not suggested to use internet cable, which is easily broken in elevator cage. So we just suggest you to select method 2 or method 3 for lift control. For biometric controller, RS485 port 2 has been used for fingerprint module. If you would use biometric controller for lift control, please change to select method 3. K keypad controller, AR-725E version 2, is not available for Power 3 now. Please change to use method 2. The wiring of e-controller is also easier than edge controller. E-controller can direct support 5 watts power for converter, so you can directly plug TTL converter to e-controller. Another important difference is that e-controller needs baud rate value 9600. Please note to switch lift control board to right value. For keypad controller AR-725E version 2, we need to use command 37 and 38 to enable lift control and set up baud rate. Just follow the manual to change the parameter as needed. And then use the same command 21 and 27 to edit the use of flow cards. The operation and the example is same as edge controller. For LCD controller, please follow the manual to select the right setting. For three kinds of methods. Method 1, quick command is 54. Change determinant 4 from default value 1 host to value 0 lift. Method 2, quick command 55. Set up extension port to 1 lift. Method 3, quick command 50. Set up UART port to 0 OEM. That means for lift control. For user flow card setting, it's same quick command as edge controller. For single flow, quick command is 24. Directly put user address and give the flow number. For multi flows, quick command is 25. Put user address and give the value for different flow. E-controller have 4 set range, set 0 to set 3 for 64 flows. We can also enable lift control function via software. It's only suitable for e-controller. Edge controller can only enable via hardware. If use method 1, please choose lift controller for RS-485 power 1. If use method 2, choose lift controller for RS-485 power 2. If use the method 3, choose lift controller for RS-485 power 3. Please note, when one of RS-485 power is using lift controller, please ensure other two RS-485 port not use the same option. For user flow card setting, it can also edit via 701 class software. Our option is almost setting as edge controller. Just note to choose the right model code. Okay, solar lift control introduction is completed. We hope today's presentation can help everyone to win more projects about lift control in building management. Thank you for your attention. See you.